Stronger than you. Focus. Now. Focus.
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 You're stronger than me.
Focus. Sam.
You won.
Senua, go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
The darkness took her life, and it will take yours.
This is taking you
further and further into it.
Surrender to the darkness.
The darkness is here.
Life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Thank you.
is wrought and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve of the whole God? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just crouch. What hope is there for you, even if a soul could be rescued? Do you think he'd thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
She gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Simba was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help. A little hope.
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there.
Listen to us.
Sit.
Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look?
Does she know the way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look up. So clever.
Did you? There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the
don't,
door.
No, go in. Don't open
the
door.
What's it?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How will you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Oh, my God. Something else is coming.
Keep alert.
Keep your torch up.
No.
Is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and that they won't be with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen
to them.
Do you
see them? Do you see their faces?
He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father, Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
She'll have to go under.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
The torch will go out.
Don't let the torch go out.
She has to be shown to it.
She can't do it.
Stop. Get out. The light's gone out. Run. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What was that?
Where's the next? Do you want to find? I can feel that you want to find.
Why are you doing this?
These bodies.
Rhian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rhian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rhian reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rhian go in search of Fafnir.
Lighting the torch.
It's not gonna help her.
She's lighting the flame.
Reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
So.
not. It's gonna run out soon. She hasn't got much time.
It's gonna burn out. She's too slow.
So
it's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid little thing.
Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dillian.
Thank you. She should have known. She should have known.
Why doesn't she learn?
She learns.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all. Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
What's she doing?
She's lighting a horse.
She's making light.
She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe. What's her plan? What's she thinking?
She's going to get there.
You killed us.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie. Sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian eats Fafnir's roasted heart and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest to ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Thank you.
people think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel.
He tried to fix her with his rituals. Kept her trapped in that hole.
She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness.
Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. But maybe Delian would still be alive.
I am so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
The shadow. Listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. Go without it. And feel me to collect those flowers. This time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago.
Oh, no.
But you have conquered your darkness at every turn.
Stay alert, Senua.
You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
Then take me to the mountain.
To trust him.
As deep as we can go.
No.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him. Show it.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.
What else can she do? Nothing. She doesn't want to tell us. She has nothing. She has nothing left.
She's come this far. She wants to go forward.
She wants this. This it.
She wants to save Delian's soul. She must listen to the Hela's gaze, searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Delian. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
She's done it.